Hi, my name is Shez, and you are watching Project Food Garden. We are in the first week of Jan, and like I said in my previous video, we will be doing a series of episodes on which we will try and cover each and every variety that we are doing. So I have covered one black and variety. We've got quite a few more to review, but the second one that I needed to cover, which is quite close to my heart, is this is also an indeterminate variety, but it's on the cherry side. It's a cherry tomato, Sun Gold. I've procured two plants of Sun Gold, and it has been an experience raising these plants. Cherry tomatoes, as compared with the other indeterminate variety, they're quite different in their approach, and supporting them and taking care of them is a little bit different as compared with the normal indeterminate variety. So without any further ado, let's go and show you the two plants that I'm doing and how well they're doing. So on the other flip side, apart from the black varieties that we are doing, the cherry varieties that I've chosen, Sun Gold is like on top of the list for this spring. So I've got two plants of Sun Gold. This is indeterminate, yet this is not the heirloom Sun Gold. I've procured the plants from a local gardener here in Christchurch. This is the variety which has been germinated within a local nursery. I've not germinated these, but I wanted to do a quick review on these because I personally really like this cherry tomato variety. So as you can see in the bottom, they have developed good healthy chunky trunks, and they're moving upwards, and I'm supporting this plant to the maximum. It has started converting fruit as well. This is considered to be one of the most tastiest tomatoes amongst the cherry tomato family. So things to consider, because this is like this variety, it's more like a vine version of what you would get. See, it's profoundly creating loads of blossom. And if I move a few steps back, you would see that I've got this whole system that I've developed for all the cherry tomatoes that I'm doing. And in about, again, 8 weeks time, it has started coming up. It's gone up to almost 3 foot. And even in these 3 foot, it has created quite a few amount of fruit. I mean, I'm quite chuffed with the way it is fruiting. And it's creating beautiful clusters. Beautiful clusters. And there is no blossom end rot, and whatever blossom it's creating, it's converting into fruit straight away. So I'm quite liking what I'm looking at through the eye of the camera even right now. I mean, it's looking really, really good. So because this is also an indeterminate variety, so it would keep growing. And as like everything else that I'm doing, I've only got two plants. So my intent is to support all the trunks that are coming out. As you can see, that's trunk number one. That's not the main trunk. That's trunk number two. And there you have trunk number three. And there we have trunk number four. And we've got a few of few more trunks that are coming up. There's another one. So if I would go on the other side, you'd see that it's I'm using hosiery to support the plant, and I'm giving it full opportunity to create as much blossom as it can. And with hosiery, I'm planning to support it, and so far it's looking really good. So these blossom that you're looking at right now, it is a plant which has got open pollinated blossom, so you don't need to worry a lot about it. I've already shown you the kind of fruit it's developing, and it's looking really good. I mean, I'm quite impressed with the way it's it has behaved. I mean, it is in a spot where if I could show you the sun, it comes out from this side, and this aisle is the first one to receive the sunlight in the morning. So these plants are doing really good. I'm as like other varieties that I'm doing, I'm supporting them with multiple trunks, and if you want to grow this, make sure that you provide them with ample support. If you're growing them in a pot, it's good to put a cage around it, but because I don't believe in growing tomatoes in pots, I would always prefer growing them outside in the open. This is again for a cherry tomato. These two plants so far, they've proved to be quite hardy. We have had quite a few cold spells, which has happened, and it has impacted a few of other varieties. But Sun Gold has so far been right spot on as far as the health is concerned, and the way it is progressing, it's doing really, really well. And I would, I can easily see them getting onto this net in the next few days. It has starting coming up to this point. I've started tying them up, and you can see it has come up to this point, which is like 4-4. So it's quite easy to grow these. Make sure when you grow this variety, you are providing, I've always said that, because it's, for me, it's very critical. You are providing it ample support, and give your tomato plants a chance to produce as much blossom as you can, and give them more ability to spread out as much as you can in within a reason. I mean, if you look in this aisle, I've got one plant here, and then I've got two here, and then I've got quite a few sweet hundreds. I'm not going towards sweet hundred as yet, but because this review is about Sun Gold, it's probably one of the best tasting. And like I said, this is the first review. So once we get to the point where we would harvest these tomatoes, we will definitely do a review of how Sun Gold will measure up as far as the taste is concerned. I'm quite chuffed with this variety that I'm doing, and thanks to one of my really good friends, friend Jacob, who has given me these two seedlings. Rest assured, they have not come from the nursery. They were germinated within the house. So technically, that's why I say that 98% of what I'm doing is home germinated. So finally, things to consider when you're doing Sun Gold. It pretty much goes back to the basic. When you do like any other plants, you have to ensure that the aeration, look at that. You have to ensure that the aeration is good from the bottom. Minimum 6, maximum 12 inches needs to be right on, cleared like a shaved chicken. So this is exactly what I've done. You can see all the bottom is clean. That's why they're flourishing on the top. It's, I would say, in my experience, one of the most easiest varieties to grow and to enjoy. So I'm sure we will be doing another review on these babies pretty soon. This is probably the one that we would come back to you really soon in future with a taste review and the fruit review as well. So let's move on. So you've seen how we are raising the Sun Gold variety. Now, fair warning for everybody who's living in New Zealand, it would be quite difficult to procure the seed for this as well. And like I said, I ordered these a long time ago, and a friend of mine who had the seed, he raised a few seedlings, his name's Jacob, and he was kind enough to sell me two of these seedlings, and they're doing really good. So for me, it would not be a problem in the future to grow Sun Gold again. And as far as the taste is concerned, everything that I've seen so far on the web about the taste of Sun Gold, it gets me quite excited to try this myself. So as like all the other varieties that we are doing, we will be doing a taste test and further reviews for this as well. And because this is an indeterminate variety, I'm hoping that it would grow up till this point as well. It's going to climb all the way up, and it's not a plant, it's a vine, so it would be interesting, you know, working with this plant. So on that note, I hope you would like this variety. I'm quite excited about the Sun Gold. Its color is so beautiful. Once the fruit would mature, I've given you a bit of preview, it's developing amazing clusters. That's the beauty of cherry tomato, and it's raising amazing set of blossom. So I'm quite excited about that as well. So in time, we will do another review, and we will come back to you with all the other varieties that we are doing as well. Every day, we'll try and upload more videos about what we are growing
And we'll try and present you in a way that if you want to grow this, how you would go about it. So let us know what you think about it. And I hope you like this episode as well. If you have any question, drop them down in the comments, and more than happy to answer. I try and answer all the questions and feedback that comes on the channel as soon as I read those messages. Welcome to all the new subscribers. The summer is now getting to a point where everything is going to be about harvesting. So exciting times for us ahead. And on that note, we'll bid you goodbye. Take really good care of yourself. Make sure you're staying safe in the pandemic. And we'll see you soon again with another episode. Have a lovely morning, afternoon, evening, and night, wherever you are. Have a good day. Bye.